Let's derive the mean and variance of the binomial distribution. Here's the probability mass function for the binomial distribution, and I sometimes take a bit of a shortcut and write this as p of little x. And a binomial random variable can take on whole number values between 0 and n. And you may have been told previously that the mean of a binomial random variable, or the expectation of a binomial random variable x, is equal to n times p. And sigma squared, or the variance of a binomial random variable x, is equal to n times p times 1 minus p. In this video, I'm going to mathematically derive that mean and that variance. I'm going to do this in two ways, the easy way and the hard way. The easy way assumes that we already know the mean and variance of a Bernoulli random variable, and the hard way starts from scratch. First, the easy way. A binomial random variable can be thought of as the sum of n independent Bernoulli random variables, each with mean p and variance p times 1 minus p. The mean and variance of a Bernoulli random variable is not too hard to derive, and I do that in another video. If we let u1 through un be independent Bernoulli random variables, where the mean or expectation for each of them is p, and the variance for each of them is p times 1 minus p, then our binomial random variable x is the sum of these n random variables, and the expectation of our binomial random variable x is the expectation of the sum of the n Bernoulli random variables. And using properties of expectation, this is simply the sum of the expectations. But each one of these has an expectation of p, and so we are simply adding up p n times, and this is equal to n times p then. And so the expectation of our binomial random variable x is n times p, or in other words, the mean of our random variable x is n times p. For the variance, we're going to use similar logic. Our binomial random variable x is the sum of these n Bernoulli random variables, and the variance of x is the variance of the sum of these n independent Bernoulli random variables. And when random variables are independent, the variance of the sum is the sum of the variances. Each one of these has a variance of p times 1 minus p, and so we are adding up p times 1 minus p n times. And so overall, we get a variance of n times p times 1 minus p. But here we didn't really start from scratch. We started with knowing the mean and variance of a Bernoulli random variable. Now let's do it from scratch, without relying on this relationship with the Bernoulli distribution, which is a little harder. I'm going to assume one thing without explanation, the binomial theorem. And if you want more information on this, a lot of people have put detailed information online. The expectation of a discrete random variable x is the sum, over all possible values of x, of each value of x times its probability of occurring. And now we substitute in the binomial distribution probability mass function here, and we have x times its probability of occurring, and we're summing over all possible values of x, which go from 0 to n. Now I'm going to open up this choose function here, the binomial coefficient, into its factorial representation. Down here, let's note right away that when x is equal to 0, this whole term is equal to 0, and so we can change this index here to starting at x is equal to 1, because when x is equal to 0, this term is 0. Also note that x factorial is equal to x times x minus 1 times all the way down to 2 times 1. Or in other words, this is equal to x times x minus 1 factorial. And so we can cancel this x with the first term there and then change x factorial to x minus 1 factorial. Let's clean this up a little. We're left with this first line here. And now we're at a bit of an advantage because we know where we need to go. We know the final answer is going to be n times p. So it might help if we take an np outside of the sum and then try to show that the remaining sum is equal to 1. So I'm going to use the same logic on this term here. And instead of n factorial, I'm going to change that to n minus 1 factorial and take the n outside of the summation because it doesn't involve x. And similarly, I'm going to take a p outside here and it's going to have np times this sum, and this is going to be changed to p raised to the x minus 1. And we're left with what we have down here. Now we need to see if we can show if this sum is equal to 1. If that's equal to 1, then we're done, and the mean is equal to n times p. One thing I'm going to do to make something a little easier to see is that I'm going to express n minus x as n minus 1 minus x minus 1. And so I'm going to substitute this in to here where we see n minus x. And it'll get a little bit messy, but it's going to make something a little easier to see in a moment. And here are the results of that. We're going to see that we can use the binomial theorem to help simplify this. To make that a little easier to see, I'm going to let m equal n minus 1, and then everywhere I see an n minus 1, I'm going to replace it with m. And I'm also going to let y equal x minus 1, and everywhere I see an x minus 1, I'm going to replace that with y. But if I do that, I have to change these limits of summation. When x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1 minus 1, or 0, so I'm going to change this to y equals 0. When x is equal to n, y is equal to n minus 1, or m, so I'm going to change this to m. And we end up with this. And now I'm going to write these factorials here in terms of the binomial coefficient notation here. And then, if we look down here, this is the binomial theorem that I put up earlier. And what we've got in this sum is exactly this, with a equaling p and b equaling 1 minus p. And so we can use this binomial theorem to help us out. And now our expectation of our random variable x is going to be equal to np, and then this sum is going to be equal to p plus 1 minus p raised to the nth power. But p minus p inside the brackets is 0, and so we're left with 1 inside the brackets. And so this is just n times p times 1 raised to the m, or in other words, n times p. And so the expectation or mean of a binomial random variable x is n times p. Now let's work on the variance. The variance of a random variable x is defined to be the expectation of x minus mu squared. And so we could work that out for our discrete binomial distribution by summing over all possible values of x, x minus mu squared times p of x. But it's often easier to work with this relationship down here. This is a very handy relationship for us. The variance is going to be equal to the expectation of x squared minus the square of the expectation of x. And we've already worked this part out to be n times p. And so the question now just boils down to simply finding the expectation of x squared. The expectation of x squared is simply the sum over all x of x squared times its probability of occurring. And we can often pursue this path directly, but it's not going to be quite so easy here, since we can cancel one of these x's down below, but we're still left with another x. And we could work with that and express it in different ways, but it's often easiest to use one little trick here. We're going to work out the expectation of x times x minus 1. And this is simply the expectation of x squared minus x. So if we work this out, we're going to be able to find the expectation of x squared rather easily. And this method allows us to cancel both of these terms. So let's find this. Note that when x is equal to 0, this whole term is 0. And when x is equal to 1, we've got x minus 1 here, and so this whole term is again 0. So we can change this lower limit of summation from x equals 0 to x equals 2, because the terms are 0 at x equals 0 and x is equal to 1. And also note here that x factorial is equal to x times x minus 1 times x minus 2 factorial. And so we're going to cancel out the x times x minus 1 with this x and x minus 1, and we're going to be left with, in the bottom, x minus 2 factorial. Here's the cleaned up version. And now we can pursue a similar path to what we've already done. We'd like to have n minus 2 factorial in the numerator here, because now we have x minus 2 factorial. And we can do that using a similar logic to what we did before with x factorial. We can take out front here n times n minus 1, and what we'd be left with is n minus 2 factorial. And we'd also like to have p raised to the x minus 2, and so I'm going to take out front here a p squared, and change this to p raised to the x minus 2. And this is the cleaned up version. And again, to make something a little easier to see in a moment, I'm going to replace n minus x everywhere with n minus 2 minus x minus 2. And we're left with this. And we'll see in a moment that we can use the binomial theorem again to simplify this summation. But to make that a little easier to see, since we've got all these n minus 2s, I'm going to let m equal n minus 2, and then everywhere I see an n minus 2, I'm going to replace that with m. I'm also going to let y equal x minus 2, and everywhere I see an x minus 2, I'm going to replace that with y. But again, if I do that, I have to make sure that I have the appropriate limits of summation. Here the lower limit is at x equals 2, and y is equal to x minus 2, so we're going to change this lower limit to y equals 0, and when x is equal to n, y is equal to n minus 2, which is simply m, so I'm going to change that upper limit to m. This is the cleaned up version of what we had before, but again, by the binomial theorem, this is going to be equal to simply p plus 1 minus p, all raised to the m. But p plus 1 minus p is just 1, so 1 to the m, which is 1. And so our expectation of x times x minus 1 is equal to n times n minus 1 times p squared. And the expectation of x times x minus 1 is simply the expectation of x squared minus x. And by properties of expectation, we can split this up. So this is equal to the expectation of x squared minus the expectation of x. And that, we know now, is n times n minus 1 times p squared. But we know that the expectation of x, we just worked this out, that's np. And so the expectation of x squared is equal to n times n minus 1 times p squared plus np. And so now we're almost done. The variance of our random variable x is equal to the expectation of x squared minus the square of the expectation of x. And we just worked out that the expectation of x squared is equal to this quantity. And just before that, we worked out that the expectation of x was equal to n times p. And so now we're down to just some basic algebra. Here we could factor out an n times p and we're left with this. And then we have n times p. This is going to be n times p minus p plus 1 minus np. Np's cancel, of course, and we are left with n times p times 1 minus p. And that is the variance of a binomial random variable.